Hello everyone, this is going to be a follow-up video of the video that I made where we used the wizard to set up the controller. And in this video today, I want to show you how to assign the inputs and outputs. So as a reference, I want to refer to this button as the alarm button, the program or menu button, the back or escape button, up, enter and down. So let's go into the menu. It's going to ask us for a password. So there's three levels of users, namely user, servers, and manufacturer. The user is the 0000 password, and the manufacturer is 1234. So I want you to use the 1234 so that we have access to all the parameters. So I'm just going to go 1, 2, 3, and 4 and enter. So now we're in the main menus of the PRAC controller. So I want you to go to menu B, which is the inputs and outputs. I want you to enter. We're gonna go into status. And now we get to all the inputs and outputs. So I always like to start from the top, so digital inputs. So I want to enter. And now we have a whole lot of information and options that we can assign. So using our notes as per the previous video, we have some digital outputs, analog outputs, another analog outputs. We've got some digital inputs as safeties, some analog inputs, and another digital input. So using this information, we can now complete and further our setup of the PRAC. So common low pressure stack, yes, we do have one. And remember guys, you need to use your wiring diagram to do this. I'm just gonna go through this as randomly assigning these inputs and outputs, but use your drawing to do this. You can't use mine because your wiring diagram might be completely different. So I'm just going to assign it as number one. It's going to be a normally closed logic. Again, if yours as per your diagram is normally open, you can then choose to make it normally open. The function active or not active, like you see at the bottom, is as soon as you assigned it, you can see this alarm currently is not active. If the alarm was active, it would have shown you it's active. So let's go down. Common high pressure stat, I don't have one, so I don't assign it. If we go down, compressed inverter warning, if you have it, assign it. So I'm not going to assign it, so I'm just going to go down. Common serious alarm, do you have one? Then you've got the option to assign it. If we go down, alarm one, compressor one. So yes, I do have an alarm one. So I'm going to enter. I'm going to assign it to number two. I'm going to leave my logic as normally closed and go down. I'm going to do the same for compressor 2 and compressor 3. I'm leaving my logic as normally closed. So if we go down, you have the option for a common oil alarm, a liquid level alarm. So yes, remember we do have a liquid level. So I'm going to assign it. I'm going to leave the logic at normally closed. A fans inverter warning, a fans common overload, a heat reclaim, generic function F, G, H, I, and J. Then we have a unit on off, PRAC working status, and then we're back at the beginning. So that's our digital inputs. So if we go back one, we're going to now go to analog inputs. We're going to enter. Suction pressure probe, yes, we do have one. So I'm going to assign it to U1. It's going to be a 4 to 20 milliamp. But if you can remember, our range in my notes is a 0 to 10 bar. So we need to change it. And always, when you set up a PRAC controller, check what the OEM installed on the rack. So I'm going to make it a 0 to 10. and I'm going to have a zero calibration for this video. Okay, so we go down. Do we have a suction temperature? Yes, I do. And do I have, am I using an NTC? Or am I using a PT1000, a 0 to 10 volt? These are all your options of different probes. So 4 to 20 milliamp, 0 to 5, a HTNTC, a SPKP, a PTC, a PT500, a PT100, or a normal NTC. So for this video, I'm going to use a normal NTC and I'm going to have a zero calibration. So let's go down. Condenser pressure probe, do I have one? Yes, I do. I'm going to sign it. I'm going to choose what it is, 4 to 20 milliamp. And I'm going to leave my range at 0 to 30 as per my notes. So let's go down. So now you have more options. And remember we said we have discharge probes per compressor. But do I have a global discharge temperature? No, I don't. Do I have a liquid temperature? Do I have an external temperature? Yes, I do. So I'm going to assign it. And I'm going to make it a normal NTC with zero calibration. So if we go down, do you have a room temperature? Discharge pressure? Or compressor 1 discharge temp? Yes, I do. So I'm going to assign it. U5. And I'm going to make it HTNTCs, which is our high temperature version. And I'm going to have a zero calibration. If we go down, so compressor 2, I'm going to do the same. I'm just going to assign it to U6 and I'm going to make it an HTNTC. Next one, again the same, I'm going to assign it and I'm going to make it an HTNTC with a zero calibration. If we go down, do you have a compressor 1 oil temperature, a compressor 2 oil, 3 oil? These are all options, and now we're back at the beginning. So if when we're done with the analog inputs, we go back, and now we're going to go digital outputs. So compressor 1, I'm going to make it DO1, and my logic is going to be normally open. Compressor 2 is going to be 2, and normally open. So these are your digital outputs on top of the controller if you have a look at the physical controller. So remember guys, use your wiring diagram. Let's go down to number 3. I'm just going to assign it to 3 and normally open. My fans. Now you have the option to have a fan enable, but remember we said we've got an analog fan, so we've got an inverter fan, so I'm not going to assign this digital output. Do we have a global alarm output? No, we don't. Do we have a signal, a life signal? No, we don't. BMS force output? No, we don't. A normal alarm? No. But yes, we have a serious alarm. So I'm going to assign this to number 13. Perfect. And it's going to be a normally closed for this video. And then we're back at the beginning. So now our digital outputs are done. So if we go back, we have the last one, analog outputs. So we're going to enter. Compressor number 1 inverter. So I'm going to assign it to number 1. And as you can see, the status is 0 because it's not running. If we go down, we have inverter for the fans, so I'm going to assign it to number 2. And the status is 0%. And back at number 1. So you can see when the controller compiles all your information from the wizard, it only allows you to assign what you have configured. So let's say we configured another analog output. We would have had the option to assign one, but because we didn't, it only allows you to assign what you've configured. And then that is done for our inputs and outputs video. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.